A mother settles with the county years after her son died in foster care. Team 10 breaks down the details of the $500,000 agreement.
Plus, the county is getting hundreds of millions of dollars from the federal government for COVID relief. How they just decided to spend that money.
And we catch up with Transportation Secretary Pete Buttigieg as negotiations over President Biden's infrastructure plan fall apart. Why Buttigieg thinks the plan will be good for San Diego.
ABC 10 News at 6 starts now.
San Diego County will pay $500,000 to the mother of a toddler who died in foster care. Tyler Walter died 2 months after being placed with a foster parent. Good evening. I'm Kimberly Hunt.
And I'm Lindsay Pena. Team 10 investigator Adam Rakusin has been tracking this case for more than 2 years. He digs into the settlement and what exactly the county agreed to.
His laugh was infectious. He had a smile that could melt the hearts of anyone who met him. That's how those who knew Tyler Walter describe him. Tyler should be a little more than 4 years old now. But instead of playing at a park with friends, he died in the parking lot of a Long Beach park 2 years ago.
And the victim here was a baby. And the price he paid was his life.
Sean McMillan is an attorney for Tyler's mom. She sued the county of San Diego and several social workers, claiming wrongful death and failure to provide minimally adequate care and ensures continued safety, among other things. Her lawsuit claimed it took just 3 months in San Diego County's care for Tyler to turn from a happy and healthy toddler into a dead one. In June of 2018, Tyler was taken away from his mother after a search of her house uncovered drugs. Social workers placed Tyler with his mother's 19-year-old relative who lived in Long Beach. It's a move child advocate experts have questioned.
You favor relatives. Statutorily, we want to favor relatives, and we do. But usually we're talking about grandparents or uncles or aunts or sisters or brothers of the parent, that kind of person.
Now, 2.5 years after filing her lawsuit, Tyler's mom and the county have agreed to end the case. According to a final court document, a judgment was entered in favor of Lisa Walter, Tyler's mom, in the total amount of $500,000. It says that money includes all attorney's fees, costs, and other fees accrued by Walter and her attorneys. Court documents show, according to the county, judgment is not an admission of liability by the county or any social workers named in the case. While the case may be over and both sides move forward, it's important to remember one person won't get that chance. His name is Tyler James Walter. Adults were put in charge of his life to give him a chance to flourish. Instead, Tyler died before he could reach two. Adam Rakusin, ABC 10 News.
Team 10 reached out to the county for a comment. They declined. You can see Team 10 stories on this case and their broader coverage of the county's foster care system. Just go to 10news.com and click on the Team 10 section.
The family of the San Diego woman who was shot and killed while breaking into the U.S. Capitol is now suing. These were the moments that rioters were smashing windows to get onto the House floor. Babbitt was shot while climbing through a broken window. Her family wants the name of the officer who killed her to be revealed. They say that she shouldn't have been shot because she was unarmed. The Department of Justice is not charging the officer over the shooting. A Marine Corps general is being relieved from his duties after last summer's deadly training accident off San Clemente. 8 Marines and a sailor died when the amphibious assault vehicle sank. The Marine Corps says Major General Robert Castelvie failed to properly train and evaluate the platoon before the accident. The Marine Corps previously suspended Castelvie from his duties as Inspector General.
Now to the coronavirus. San Diego is now officially in the yellow tier. And of course, that will only last a week because the state is reopening and doing away with the color tiers next week. Some of the biggest changes this week: indoor bars can now open at 25% or 100 people, whichever is fewer. Restaurants and gyms can go up to 50% capacity. Outdoor gatherings can now have up to 200 people. Outdoor entertainment venues can open at 67% capacity. And here are the latest COVID numbers in San Diego. Today, the county announced 62 new cases for a total close to 281,000. Sadly, one more person died. 3,765 San Diegans have now lost their lives to COVID-19.
About $650 million in federal COVID relief funding is coming to San Diego. And today, the county supervisors approved a plan to split it up. ABC 10 News reporter Mimi Alcala spent the day looking deeper into how that money will be spent.
After an hours-long meeting Tuesday, the County Board of Supervisors approved a plan on how to spend the nearly $650 million from the American Rescue Plan Act. About half of the money will go to covering costs related to the pandemic and COVID-19 response, as well as any future expenses. The rest is spread through different programs and services to help those facing homelessness, small businesses and nonprofits, mental health services, and much more. And about $36 million will go to hazard pay to county essential employees who work throughout the pandemic.
These workers still had to continue to go in. There were workers that were in hospital settings, medical workers who worked in the jails. There were medical workers that worked at the psych hospital, social workers that had to make house visits.
David Garcias is the president of SEIU Local 221, the union representing county workers. He says many risked their lives working in person throughout the pandemic. They even rallied virtually last year, calling for extra PPE and hazard pay. During public comment at the board's meeting, a county adult protective services specialist spoke of the risks coworkers endured during home visits, not knowing if people were COVID positive.
We weren't compensated for the extra risk, for the stress. We know that there have been tragic outcomes for some, including among our fellow county workers. And I think we should have been paid at the time. Now there is the opportunity to make us whole.
But there was a bit of pushback on the item.
I just can't, in good conscience, give COVID bonuses to those who never missed a paycheck, have a guaranteed outcome with the retirement, and have the best health care.
In the end, the funding was approved. We're told discussions are still underway about how and when the money will be allocated.
Those folks that stayed there and did the job, and we need to honor them for all the hard work they did to make sure people were taken care of.
Mimi Alcala, ABC 10 News.
And here is the latest on that fire burning on Camp Pendleton that we've been monitoring since 4. The base released this map to give an idea of where the 1,000-acre fire was burning on base. There is no word on the fire's progress, but there is barely any smoke seen on the SDG&E cameras now. Earlier, heavy smoke could be seen as the base announced evacuations of areas on the base near the fire. The base is calling it the Sierra Fire. We will continue to monitor that situation.
A group of UC San Diego students are calling on the university to defund the campus police department. Students and professors who are part of a group called Cops Off Campus rallied downtown today outside the city offices. We spoke with one student who says that she was recently racially profiled and stopped by campus police twice in one night. She says they tried to bully and intimidate her, though she says she wasn't doing anything suspicious.
And we're also demanding that the university puts in non-policing forms of anti-violent interventionists that respond and aren't actually the creators of this violence, this sexual violence, and this mental violence, and this spiritual violence that they're enduring and putting onto students.
We reached out to UC San Diego Police. They told us that Carrington was stopped because her license plate was obstructed from view, and she was not given a ticket.
Orange County's first female helicopter fire pilot is suing the agency. Desiree Horton claims despite her experience and glowing reviews from former employers and colleagues, the Orange County Fire Agency failed her after her one-year probationary period. In the lawsuit, Horton claims she was forced to work in a hostile environment in where she was ignored, undermined, disrespected, disparaged, and made to feel as though she was incompetent.
I was set up to fail, and I was never given the opportunity to succeed. It was clear to me that women weren't wanted at OCFA.
The girls graduating high school right now who are entering the fire pilot cadet program, they deserve more.
A spokesperson for the Orange County Fire Association says they can't comment on pending litigation.
Parks across the county will be getting some much-needed improvements. Today, the Board of Supervisors agreed to add or replace playgrounds at 10 parks. In addition, they'll also install shade structures over the playgrounds at 10 parks. Most are in the East County, El Cajon, Julian, Lakeside, Pine Valley, Ramona, and Spring Valley. North County parks getting improvements are Del Mar and Forest Ranch. Also included is Otay Lakes County Park in Chula Vista.